Most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living and a return worth having. The failure of the science community is to think that they have rights over people and strangers that they never received permission to study. There is a liar in every family, and that family has a liar. What I mean is that every family lies. You see, a family that lies in a way that protects a family is one kind of family. A family that divides itself and lies to harm a member is a different kind of family. Underneath our federal laws, our U.S. Constitution, we say that American citizens have the right to their lives. What we imply through the Constitution is that every citizen naturally born here has the right to prove and to pursue life, liberty, and what we say as the pursuit of happiness. It is absolutely truthful that there is no guarantee that a person will be happy in America. But it is absolutely truthful that every human being in front of the Lord God's house, in the sky, in the heaven, wherever you think that a God like Jesus, if you're a person allegedly of faith, might reside. And when I say this to you, I'm going to say this to you as clearly and as succinctly as a pagan priest can do. My life is mine. Whose life do you own? I'm asking you this very clearly because in my life, I have seen men and women trying to own my life. They try to own my life by being a consistent person in my life. They try to use my life by being a user of my skill sets and talents in a way that gave them benefit, and then they got mad about it because they didn't understand that at that moment in time, the industry was launching a new visuality of people called avatars. Avatars are usually cartoon or character graphics that show a person visibly as a cartoon. In my work, I often had to buy graphics, but in my work and at that time in the industry, we could buy them from a really good company that said, you may use this based on these ownership rights. Please select what you want and pay for it. What I loved about one of the companies I used to work with was the freedom and flexibility we had with the graphics and photographs we could purchase. Really high quality professional work, so we didn't always have to do the photography. We could simply align it up with graphics and the projects we were working on because we paid for those rights. Copyright law is protected by the owner of the photograph or the publishing house that sells it. When a publishing house is bought out by a conglomerate, they might try to change the rules on people going forward, but they don't have the right to retroactively pursue people who are doing things differently under different laws. The minute that conglomerate company that I did not like in the journalism field started to purchase that house was when I lost interest in that company. I no longer wanted to pursue or be involved with the place that I was buying from years. When it comes to my artwork that I have created for my company, it is completely mine. Because what I had to do all the time was to take the GIF files and the other types of files that we get from those companies in a different type of program called Adobe InDesign or Adobe Illustrator and change them. And when I would change them, it would become completely mine under copyright law because I am changing part of it. But in my heart, in my soul, I never denied where I received the graphic or who designed it, especially a cartoonist that I used quite a lot, where he sold the entire CD of his work to me. And I loved it. It went really well in supporting a particular business that did a lot of musicals and a lot of playthings for kids. I was able to redesign things, recolor things, redo things, and keep the basic premise of the animal or the artwork. But I would change things completely by changing hair color, changing color of clothing, changing even lines of a graphic of me that a cartoonist in the community I paid to design of me and my late spouse. When I talk about how I've done things, there will be some bastard in a community that's trying to play me, trying to use my work, trying to be me, trying to steal from me, trying to commit fraud by using my work to promote their life into something else. That is a form of abuse. It is a financial abuse, and it is absolutely fraud. You did not purchase those items from me. You did not design my angel cards. I did. You did not know how I designed the whole thing. You don't know the programs I used to do it. And if you can figure it out, great. But I doubt you have the design files. And my guess is I have siblings that are shitbags about my life, who are probably deleting all my work so that I have no history in life. But what I can say to them is God can do the same to them. God can delete their life. When you go to heaven and stand before Jesus, what are you going to say to him? Well, you gave me this life to focus on my life, but I decided instead to attack my sibling's life, ruin our family, destroy the love that was there, and obliterate my children's understanding of the law in America.